Hello, my name is Mike, and welcome back to Dragon Age Origins. Last time, well, not a whole lot went great for us. Duncan died, and the king died, and we were branded enemies of the state, and the traitor is apparently the king now. Just a lot of bad things happened, but we're still alive, myself and Alistair here. Also, we recruited Morrigan to help us, and then we dressed her up in some nicer clothing. We're trying to find a better outfit for her while we're here. And then I also got this dog that I set on fire, and he's totally fine with that. He is totally fine with being a flaming dog, which is fine. I'm just going to use him to intimidate my enemies, I suppose. There are a couple of main story missions that have been added to my journal at the request of Alistair. He wants me to go talk to some dwarves, talk to some elves, talk to some humans, and also a couple other things. Yeah, talk to some mages. So I'm going to go back to the mages' circle eventually, it sounds like.
I have a wonder, Alistair, if you will indulge me.
Do I have a choice?
Of the two of you that remain, are you not the senior Grey Warden here? I find it curious that you allow another to lead while you follow.
You find that curious, do you?
In fact, you defer to a new recruit. Is this the policy of the Grey Wardens, or simply a personal one?
What do you want to hear? That I prefer to follow? I do.
You sound so very defensive.
Couldn't you crawl into a bush somewhere and die? That would be great, thanks.
That was a little bit of interesting banter. I'd like to hear more of that. What was it talking about? Ah, yes, I have a couple of important story missions to do, but first we're stopping by this little town called Lothering. I guess to get outfitted with some supplies, maybe find some equipment. I don't know exactly why we're here, but yeah, we'll just poke around and talk to some folks. Maybe get a little more information on the area at hand. Got a Templar here. Templars and mages don't exactly get along, so we'll see if he tries to start something with me.
Move on if you can. Lothering's lost.
What do you mean Lothering is lost?
We've had refugees streaming from the south for the last 2 days. The Chantry and Tavern are full to bursting. There simply isn't enough food to go around, and we Templars can barely keep order. You'd be better off elsewhere, my friend.
Well, we're just passing through, so thanks for the warning.
Best of luck, wherever you might go.
Yep, fair enough. Yeah, there are a lot of refugees scattered around here because the Darkspawn from the south have started killing everything, just absorbing it up, just black ooze rising from the south. So everyone's running north, trying to find some refuge, but...
Ah, look how they moan and wail and gnash their teeth. It is sad to watch how helplessly they scurry about.
You have... no charisma, Morrigan. You are just like... it's like you're trying to be dark, but instead you're just kind of pathetic. Robbed man and robbed family. Hello, robbed family.
Greetings to you, good sir. If it isn't too much to ask, might you spare some bread or anything?
Here's 50 silvers.
Thank you. That's very kind.
Bless you, I knew another elf would help us.
But it's not because I'm an elf, it's because I'm a Grey Warden. Let all your friends know that Grey Wardens are not terrible people.
Thank you again for helping us. It's been difficult since we were robbed.
I met the bandits. I drove them off.
That's wonderful news. Perhaps our belongings are still there.
I can't thank you enough, friend. Even if we don't get everything back, it's good to know others will be safe.
Yes, a very good deed indeed.
And Eileen spoke unto the masses, my hearth is yours, my bread is yours, my life is yours. For all who walk in the sight of the Maker are one.
Hello, priest.
Let all repeat the chant of light. Only the word dispels the darkness upon us.
He can't answer you. He's Chanter Devons.
What's a chanter?
One of them that can only say the chant of light. His board... has letters of good deeds to be doing. My father fixed Widow Allison's roof once, and the charter paid him, he did.
A learned child is a blessing upon his parents and unto the Maker.
Oh, so you pretty much just speak in scripture. Okay. It's like a vow of silence because you can't talk normally.
Unless it's the chant of light, no.
And so Rajmael in the heathen temple recanted. Speak only the word. Sing only the chant. Then the Golden City is thine, spoke Andraste.
Wow, he'd probably be better off taking a vow of silence.
Sometimes we throw pebbles at him. Doesn't work either.
Enchantress says what?
What?
Oh, you got him to speak. Ha!
What hath man's sin wrought?
Oh, he cheated.
No, he saved it. He's clever. So, yeah, a notice board. Or I guess it's a chanter's board.
Can I get you a ladder so you can get off my back?
A bandit quest? Sure, let's take out some bandits. Now, what do we have here? A Templar and a priest and a couple of farmers.
There is nowhere to run! This evil will cover the world like a plague of locusts!
Please, you're scaring the children!
Better to slit their throats now than let them suffer at Darkspawn hands! There! One of their minions is already amongst us! This man bears their evil stench! Can you not see the vile blackness that fills him?
Hello, my name is Mike.
Darkspawn will feast on our flesh! Everyone will die! Can you all not smell the evil? This one is tainted!
Better tainted by blood than fear.
Are you calling me a coward?
No, I'm calling you an idiot. Listen to yourself.
I have shamed my ancestors. But the blackness will come.
He was right, wasn't he? There's no hope for us.
There's hope. Muster your courage.
You're right. We can't give up.
But we can't fight. What are we supposed to do?
We can't lie down and die either. We must go north to Denerim.
Your king is dead. There is no hope.
Are you done? Was that the last one? You just had to get one final chant in before you left? Good. Well, now this town is a little quieter. And the refugees have a little more peace of mind. They're welcome.
Back off. I have the right to charge what I wish.
You profit from their misfortune. I should have the Templars give away everything in your carts.
You wouldn't dare. Any of you step too close to my goods and I'll...
It's so nice to see everyone working together in a crisis. Warms the heart.
Oh, you there. You look able. Would you care to make a tiny profit helping a beleaguered businessman?
Well, sure, I suppose. Why would I want to help you?
Didn't I mention profit?
He is charging outlandish prices for things people desperately need. Their blood is filling his pockets.
I have limited supplies. The people decide what those supplies are worth to them.
You bought most of your wares from these very people last week. Now they flee for their lives, and you want to talk business?
Look, stranger, I've 100 silvers if you drive this rabble off, starting with that priest. I'm an honest merchant, nothing more.
He's kind of got a point, but don't you think you're being a little unscrupulous as well?
Would it help these folks if they could buy no goods at all?
They spend their very last coin because they are desperate, and this man preys upon them as surely as the bandits outside the city.
I'm not arguing anymore. Drive off this woman and get your 100 silvers. Otherwise, I'm taking my wagon and leaving.
All right, you two. Find a compromise or I'll beat your heads in.
Perhaps. If that woman agrees, I'm allowed to charge something.
Do what you must. So long as the prices do not beggar the needy.
Fine, fine. Done. And since you don't look too needy, normal prices for you.
So, we have come to solve every squabble in the village personally. My, but the Darkspawn will be impressed.
Thank you for your generous assistance. May the Maker watch over your path.
Morrigan disapproves. Well, Morrigan can shove it. Hello, Sir Maron.
If you seek refuge in the Chantry, there's simply no room left.
Do I look like a refugee?
So many are coming to Lothering. I make no assumptions. Priests are within if you seek to offer devotion to the Maker, however. May he protect us all.
Did you know about the bandits that I just took care of on the highway?
Did you drive them off? Well, Sir Bryant will appreciate that.
Then I'll go talk to him. Alright, I'll see you around. Maker bless you and all that. Hello, Sir Bryant.
Yes? Who might you be?
Just a couple of problem solvers. I am called Mike. I'm a Grey Warden.
I see. I am Ser Bryant, commander of the Lothering Templars. Tern Loghain declared all Grey Wardens traitors responsible for the king's death. You know this, I hope.
I had heard the rumors.
I don't believe the Grey Wardens would be as careless or malicious as the Tern claims. But either way, there it is. It is best you not linger, though. Just in case.
Good advice. Also, I took care of some bandits outside the village. Are you happy about that?
Maker's breath. How many times must we drive them off?
Well, one less.
Indeed? They're gone?
It's true. I saw the bastard running for the hills myself.
That's an impressive feat indeed. Will you accept a small reward for your efforts?
I could keep an eye out for trouble for the right pay.
I wish I could afford such help, to be truthful. Take your reward, at any rate. It is all I have to offer. Travel safely, and may the Maker watch over you.
Yes, and Maker's blessings upon you too, and thank you for the 20 silvers. Hello, revered mother.
Will you be making a donation to the Chantry, my friend? You look like you have salvaged more of value than most who make it here. Might I suggest 30 silver?
I just earned 20 silver. Yeah, sure, 30 silver.
Thank you, my son. What can I do for you, then?
I am a Grey Warden, and I need all the help I can find.
A Grey Warden? Here?
Probably should not be announcing that.
You put me in a difficult position. You must know that Tern Loghain declared the Grey Wardens to be outlaws.
Yeah, I have heard that, but it's a lie, because it's Loghain who betrayed the king, not us.
Tern Loghain? That is as hard for me to believe as his condemnation of the Wardens. There is a price on your head. Lay low, and I promise to keep your presence a secret. That is the best I can do. Now, if there is nothing else...
Can you provide us any help at all?
I cannot help you without risking the safety of this village and chantry. The best I can do is keep your presence a secret. I am sorry.
All right, salutations.
So let's talk about your mother.
Lord.
I'd rather talk about your mother.
Well, there's nothing to talk about. And besides, isn't your mother a scary witch who lives in the middle of a forest? Much more interesting.
To you, perhaps. You would find the moss growing upon a stone interesting.
You know what's more interesting than that? Apostates. Mages outside of the tower. That's illegal.
I'm an apostate now.
You did not read that in a book somewhere, did you? I hope the small letters did not strain you overmuch.
Oh, we could not talk about your mother. That works for me.
Does anyone want to know about my mother? No? Alright, never mind then.
So, I take it you did not enjoy your Templar training?
That's directed at me,
I think. It's not me.
Do you see any others about who have failed at their religious instruction?
Ouch.
I didn't fail. I was recruited into the Grey Wardens.
And if you had not been recruited, what would have happened instead?
I would have turned into a drooling lunatic, slaughtered the Grand Cleric, and run through the streets of Denerim in my small clothes, I guess.
You got a bed for the night. You taken care of. Don't suppose you know anything of tonics, medicines, or herbs.
I know a little bit about herbalism, actually. I've been putting points into herbalism because I don't know where to put my points, so I've just been dumping into herbalism and hoping that's a good idea. But I'm not sure. I am a bit of an expert, actually.
Maker's breath. You've answered my prayers. All manner of travelers come through, many injured or sick. We do our best, but we're out of supplies. There's medicinal herbs in the woods to the north. If you make a few poultices, I'll scrape together some sort of payment. I'll write all you need to know in this note here.
All right, I'll take a look at that and try and fetch a few plants for you. Okay, so I have enough ingredients to make some of those health potions that she wants, but I need a couple of flasks to put them in. I don't know where I would get flasks. I'll have to look around for a vendor who sells flasks.
Well, look what we have here, then. I think we've just been blessed.
Uh-oh. Loghain's men. This can't be good.
Didn't we spend all morning asking about an elf by this very description? And everyone said they hadn't seen one.
It seems we were lied to.
I just got into town.
Gentlemen, surely there's no need for trouble. These are no doubt simply more poor souls seeking refuge.
They're more than that. Now stay out of our way, sister. You protect these traitors, you'll get the same as them.
It looks like you want a fight. Is there any way I can talk you down?
I doubt he would listen. He blindly follows his master's commands.
I am not the blind one. I served at Ostagar, where the Tern saved us from the Grey Warden's treachery. I serve him gladly. Enough talk. Take the Warden into custody. Kill this sister and anyone else that gets in your way.
Right. Let's make this quick.
Well, that seems excessive. Okay. Then, let's just kill these soldiers, I guess.
All right, you've won. We surrender.
Good. They've learned their lesson and we can all stop fighting now.
Well, let's see. Again, a lot of different options here. I could kill them. I could warn them. I could spare them. I could tell them to send a message. The Grey Wardens didn't betray King Kaelin. Loghain did.
I was there. The Tern pulled us out of a trap.
More like he scampered away with his tail between his legs. Just get out of here. Just leave. I'm not gonna fight you.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
You're stupid.
I apologize for interfering, but I couldn't just sit by and not help.
Yes, thanks for assisting in that battle then.
I am glad you found it in your heart to offer those men mercy. Let me introduce myself. I am Liliana, one of the lay sisters of the Chantry here in Lothering. Oh, I was.
You aren't anymore?
I joined the Chantry to live a life of religious contemplation. But I am no priest, not even an initiate.
Well, my name is Mike, and it's a pleasure to meet you.
They said you were a Grey Warden. I'm surprised you're an elf, but elves must want the Blight defeated as much as humans, no? I know after what happened you will need all the help you can get. That's why I'm coming along.
Oh, what skills do you possess?
I had a dream. A vision.
More crazy? I thought we were all full up.
Look at the people here. They are lost in their despair, and this darkness, this chaos, will spread. The Maker doesn't want this. What you do, what you are meant to do, is the Maker's work. Let me help.
Yeah, again, I need more than just prayers.
I can fight. I can do more than fight. As I said, I was not always a lay sister. I put aside that life when I came here. But now, if it is the Maker's will, I will take it up again. Gladly. Please let me help you.
I suppose I won't turn away help when it is offered, so welcome to the team.
Perhaps your skull was cracked worse than Mother thought.
Thank you. I appreciate being given this chance. I will not let you down.
And what a great coincidence, because I just kicked Morrigan out of the team.
Blast and damnation.
Because she's very rude.
Indeed.
Actually, I have a mod on that allows me to have this dog with me as an accessory fifth companion, so I can have all four of us together on a team. I guess including the dog, all five of us. So, okay, you get to stick around a little bit longer until I find someone who's less sassy. Barkeep Danil, what information do you have?
There's knights from Redcliffe wandering the countryside, looking for the place where Andraste's sacred ashes are said to lie. Can you believe that? The urn holding her ashes is a myth. And yet these knights say they were sent to find it anyhow to heal Arleman. I didn't even know he was ill.
Well, that's not good, because Arleman is the person that Alstar wanted to see.
Luck speed your way.
Did you hear that, Alstar? He said that Arleman is sick. Maybe we should go talk to him first. Maybe that should be our priority after all.
You're here about food. Take it up with that bleeding runt by the Chantry. I got other gear to sell.
I like gear. I don't want food. So, show me what you got. He's got flasks. I'll take flasks so I can make a couple of potions, please. Thank you. And now I can use my improved herbalism, right? I thought I could. There we go. And now we make some lesser health poultices. And now we can go finish that quest. Ooh, and I got a little achievement for doing that. Neat.
Abana kyun, maras shokra, ananisam kyun.
Hello, person speaking a foreign language with an exclamation mark over their head.
You aren't one of my captors. I have nothing to say that would amuse you, elf. Leave me in peace.
What are you? What are you?
A prisoner. I'm in a cage, am I not? I've been placed here by the Chantry.
The revered mother said he slaughtered an entire family, even the children.
It is as she says. I am Sten of the Beresad, the vanguard of the Kunari peoples.
I am Mike, pleased to meet you.
You mock me. Or you show manners I have not come to expect in your lands. Though it matters little now, I will die soon enough.
This is a proud and powerful creature, trapped as prey for the Darkspawn. If you cannot see a use for him, I suggest releasing him for mercy's sake alone.
Mercy? I wouldn't have expected that from you.
I would also suggest that Alistair take his place in the cage.
Yes, that's what I would have expected.
I suggest you leave me to my fate.
I do find myself in need of skilled help. What did you do to end up in there?
I have been convicted of murder. Have the villagers not spoken of this?
I have not been paying attention, I guess. Are you guilty?
Are you asking if I feel guilt or if I am responsible for the deed? However I feel, whatever I've done, my life is forfeit now.
I'm just asking if it's justified or something. Was it murder or was it self-defense?
Death will be my atonement.
There are other ways to redeem yourself.
Perhaps. What does your wisdom say is equal to my crime?
You could defend this land against the Blight, which is probably better than just rotting in the cage.
The Blight? Are you a Grey Warden, then?
Yeah. As of about 5 hours ago, I am.
Surprising. My people have heard legends of the Grey Warden's strength and skill. Though I suppose not every legend is true.
No, I am both strength and skilled. Would the revered mother let you free?
Perhaps if you told her the Grey Wardens need my assistance. It seems as likely to bring my death as waiting here.
All right, I guess I can go talk to her.
Farewell, then.
To be left here to starve? Or to be taken by the Darkspawn? No one deserves that. Not even a murderer.
Wow. So I have Alistair and Morrigan and this new girl all agreeing that we should make sure this guy gets free. If the decision is unanimous, then sure, let's try and get this murderer free. I'm not sure why they're so eager to defend him, but okay. Sir Donald, I don't know who you are, but apparently I should talk to you.
Who? I beg your pardon. I did not see you approach.
Sir Donald? Is that you?
Alistair? By the Maker, how are you? I was certain you were dead.
Not yet. No thanks to Tern Loghain.
If Al-Eman were well, he'd set Loghain straight soon enough.
But if Al-Eman is sick, why are you here?
Our only hope now is a miracle. Every knight of Redcliffe has gone in search of the Urn of Sacred Ashes. Andraste's ashes are said to cure any illness. But I fear we are chasing a fable. With each day, my hope dims.
So your quest for the ashes brought you here for some reason?
I expected to take advantage of the Chantry's library, in fact. But my skills are better suited to battle than chasing down tales.
I was hoping to meet Al-Eman for a fact. Will he attack me on sight because I have been branded an enemy of the state?
Why is that, if I may ask?
Well, we need help against Terran Loghain.
I see. The Arl is a popular man, it's true. Terran Loghain, however, is a hero throughout Ferelden. Whatever the Terran has done or not done, the Arl remains ill or worse. That is my primary concern.
Oh, could Loghain have been involved with poisoning the Arl or something like that?
The Arl fell ill before the king died. But what if Loghain planned that too? Oh, such thoughts do not sit well with me.
We should see what's happening in Redcliffe ourselves. I believe that now more than ever.
If nothing else, I am certain you would be welcomed at Castle Redcliffe. The Arlessa is there, and she could tell you more than I could.
By the way, I found a note from your friend Sir Henrik. He was dead, and I grabbed this note to give to you, I guess.
What? And you have his locket? And a note? Maker's mercy. Thank you for giving me these. I would never have known otherwise.
Yeah, I guess he was killed by bandits at the front of the town. And if I had known that he had done that, I would have taken out those bandits, but instead I let them go. So, yeah, sorry. Sorry about your friend.
Thank you. I wonder how many of us have met similar fates on this mad quest. Thank you again, good sir. You have been most helpful.
Okay, fare thee well. Okay, revered mother.
Good day, Sister Leliana. I'm surprised to see you're still in Lothering.
It is good to see you as well, your reverence.
Is there something I can do for you, then?
for some reason, I want you to pardon this murderous Kunari that you have imprisoned.
It might have been kinder to execute him, but I leave his fate to the Maker. Why does he interest you?
What did he do? Do you have more information on this family that he killed?
He butchered an entire farmhold. Only one of the youngest hid long enough to survive. The child said his father had found the Kunari gravely wounded and took him in. That kindness was repaid with murder. The bandsman found the Kunari just standing amidst the carnage. He did not resist them.
How peculiar. I would like to free him because I might have a use for him.
Then his next victims might count you and me as their murderers.
I was thinking you might release him into my custody.
And what do you say on this, Leliana? You know your friend better than I.
I just met her like five minutes ago.
Times, Your Reverence. With us, the Kunari might do some good. I am sure of it, in fact.
Were things not so desperate? Very well, I trust you. Take these keys to his cage and make her watch over you.
Thank you, Your Reverence. Your trust is not misplaced.
I think collectively all of our trust might be misplaced. Is there a reason you guys are just kind of standing around and not following me anymore? I'm moving over here now, and you're just not following me? Oh. I must have hit a button. Okay. Weirdos. Alright, this guy. I have the key to your cage, and I'm apparently gonna let you out so you can go kill again.
You wish something more of me.
I have the key to your cage.
I confess, I did not think the priestess would part with it.
Yeah, well, she agreed to release you into my custody.
So be it. Set me free and I will follow you against the Blight.
Okay, can I trust you? How can you help us?
I have spent my life in the Vanguard. I know war, and your lands need all the help they can get.
Okay, then sure enough, you can come with me, I guess.
And so it is done. I will follow you into battle. In doing so, I shall find my atonement.
I guess thank you, Sten. I'm glad to have you with us, and I hope you don't murder us.
May we proceed? I am eager to be elsewhere.
Yes. And now I'm kicking Morrigan out.
Blast and damnation.
Yeah, well, be more pleasant next time. There we go. Got a nice, happy family now. The three of us, and the four of us, and the dog. Yes. Much more pleasant. Much, much more pleasant, I think. Now, this girl who wanted potions.
Have any luck finding herbs in the woods?
I did not need them. I made these potions without them. Here you go.
This will help many people. You're a good sort, you know.
Yes, I am. Thank you for the 50 silver.
We done heard what was said. You're a warden. I don't know if you killed King Kaelin, and make her forgive me. I don't care. But that bounty on your head could feed a lot of hungry bellies. Attack!
Well, luckily for the villagers, they're about to have a lot of meat! And now they're all dead. Wasn't even an opportunity to talk them down. They just really wanted to charge in and get killed. But I guess hunger makes people do desperate things. You know, you probably could have taken these healing poultices and sold them for money for food. But sure, yeah, no. Attacking me was probably a better plan. Good job. Okay, before we advance, I'm going to take a moment to actually get you guys better equipment. Okay, so you have different weaponry now, and I wasn't able to... Yeah, I didn't actually have any armor for you, so I'm going to have to go find or purchase some armor. Yeah, you know what? It's probably not high priority. We'll get you some armor later. Okay, I think we're done here. We've wasted enough time in this town. We got two new companions, which is good, because I don't have to deal with Morrigan's sass anymore. We're going to make our way north, and then we are going to head to Arl Eamon, wherever he might be, and maybe find this urn of sacred ashes for him. Oh, sounds like trouble.
Leave us alone.
Darkspawn, holy cow. They're all down now, right? Who are they attacking?
Mighty timely arrival there, my friend. I'm much obliged.
You're welcome.
The name's Bodon Fedic, merchant and entrepreneur. This here is my son, Sandal. Say hello, my boy.
Hello.
Road's been mighty dangerous these days. Mind if I ask what brings you out here? Perhaps we're going the same way.
Yeah, let's start a caravan. There's safety in numbers. But I doubt you want to travel with Grey Warden. We're kind of enemies of the state right now.
Grey Wardens? My, that does rather explain a lot. No offense, but I suspect there's more excitement on your path than my boy and I can handle.
Allow me to bid you farewell and good fortune, though.
Goodbye.
Now then, let's get this mess cleaned up, shall we?
Okay, well, a fond farewell to you, noble dwarf. It's a shame. It's a real shame you didn't want to come with us, because it would have been nice to have some traveling companions. But hey, I've got a bunch now, including Morrigan, so I've got more than I even want. Okay. Oh, it was a nightmare. Okay. Just having a nightmare about a dragon.
Bad dreams, huh?
No, it must have been something I ate.
Drank more like, as in the tainted blood, remember? You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde. We feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a blight.
Ah, so the Archdemon is that dragon.
I don't know if it's really a dragon, but it sure looks like one. When I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for me, too.
Not scared.
I screamed like a little girl. Duncan said he thought I had someone in my room. Not embarrassing at all. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on.
If we must. Alright, what are you barking about, dog? What's up, Poochie?
Oh, why, you little...
What happened?
Your furry friend here took offense at me getting near his food. He snapped at me, look.
Well, it was just a warning. He could have taken a hand off.
Don't you think I don't know it? Sometimes I forget that he's a war dog. That'll teach me.
Lessons hardest learned. Alright, Sten. Let's have a couple of words.
Why are we stopping?
I don't know, just kind of felt like stopping. I need to know who you are, and I need to know you won't kill me in my sleep.
There are Darkspawn to be fought. Is this delay needful?
Yes, it is. I need to know if I can trust you at my back.
I am Kunari. I have given my word to aid you. We are not people of idle promises.
You said you were in the army?
I am.
Why would the Kunari send soldiers here?
The Antam are the eyes, hands, and mouth of the Kunari. We are how my people know the world.
That doesn't really answer my question.
No, I didn't.
Ah. Okay, so you're evading my question.
Yes. There is no point to this. We are keeping the Darkspawn waiting.
Not very talkative, huh? All right. You're in such a hurry, even though you were in that cage for weeks.
You are concerned. No need. I am fit enough to fight.
All right, fine.
As you wish.
Well, fine. I'm gonna go talk to Liliana instead, because Liliana won't be so rude. Or maybe she will.
Yes?
How was your life in the Chantry?
Quiet. It was a life suited for contemplation. In the cloister, away from the fuss and the flurry of the cities, I found peace. And in that stillness, I could hear the Maker.
I really have no dog in this race. I really don't have any opinion on the Maker or the Chantry, so... Yeah, whatever.
Maybe I am wrong. But it is the Maker's place to decide if I am worthy. Not men. Not the Chantry. But there is work to be done. And I have talked enough for now.
You haven't talked at all. All you did was rant about the Chantry. I did not learn anything about you. Like, why are you a rogue? How do you know how to pick locks and stuff if you're supposed to be a religious woman? Yeah, exactly. Why would you be in Lothering's Chantry?
What is meant by someone like me?
Sanctimonious and preachy. A beautiful and charming woman. No. Yeah, none of these are... I want to ask about... Okay, you don't seem like you belong in a cloister.
Did you think I was always a cloistered sister? The Chantry provides succor and safe harbor to all who seek it. I chose to stay and become affirmed.
What were you doing before you became a sister?
I was a traveling minstrel in Orlais. Tales and songs were my life. I performed, and they rewarded me with applause and coin. And my skill in battle? Well, you pick up different skills when you travel, yes? Yes, of course. Let's move on.
Okay, traveling minstrel. That's not bad. That might add a bit more levity. Yeah. So, you're a Templar, and I'm a mage. I guess that makes us mortal enemies, huh?
No, I never actually became a full Templar. Duncan recruited me before I took my vows. I was only present during one harrowing. That was all I needed, too. I don't know how anyone could get through that. The girl they tested, she had a demon put inside her. see if she could resist. And she couldn't. We had to end it quickly. I have to say I didn't have much interest in becoming a Templar after that.
Yeah, it sounds messy, but it didn't happen to me because I am too strong-willed.
Ah, it's good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fedic, at your service, once again.
Oh.
I saw your camp and thought to myself, what safer place to rest for the evening than in the camp of a Grey Warden? I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence. How does that sound? Good? Yes?
I'm glad you decided to travel with us. Let me see your wares.
I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
And this other guy that's in my camp, Levy Dryden.
You're a hard man to find. Where are my manners? The name is Levy. Levy Dryden. Did Duncan ever mention me? Levy of the coins? Levy the trader?
Yeah, that's listed under premium content, so I'm guessing that's DLC. So, I'll do that, but things of a more pressing nature have to come first. I need to deal with Arl Eamon, because it sounds like he's sick, so the faster we get this done, the better. Also, where's Morrigan? Is she still sulking because I kicked her out of the group?
What do you wish of me?
Just wanted to ask you something.
If you must.
I did not realize that you were a shapeshifter. How did you become a shapeshifter?
I was not born such. 'Tis a skill of Flemeth's, taught over many years in the wilds. The chastened have tales of we witches, saying that we assume the forms of creatures to watch them from hiding. When a child is alone and separate from his tribe, that is when we strike, dragging the young boy kicking and screaming to our lair to be devoured. A most amusing legend.
That does sound like something you'd do.
Oh? I truly doubt that children would be worth the effort. They are filthy, smelly things full of tears and snot and trouble. Why do you ask? Is there something specific you wish to know?
I don't know, just making conversation, I suppose. Can you change into human forms as well?
I gain nothing by studying another human. I already am the same as they are. I learn nothing. So the answer is no, my human form is the only one I possess.
This is interesting. Tell me more about, how many animals have you been?
There were nights when the wilds called to me, 'tis true. You look upon the world around you and you think you know it well. I have smelled it as a wolf, listened as a cat, prowled shadows that you never dreamed existed. But my life is as a human. I am under no illusions to the contrary.
This is interesting. Can you teach me to shapeshift?
Anyone with sufficient will. But the act of transformation is a magical one. 'Tis a spell and thus requires a mage's talents.
Well, boom!
Indeed, you could learn the spells required if I cared to teach you.
Well, I have never heard of magic like that before. I was cloistered in my little tower.
No, 'tis not unheard of in the remote corners of the world. There are traditions of magic outside of the circle of magi, despite what those mages would have you believe. Some of these traditions are old, indeed, passed down as carefully guarded lore from one generation to the next. The zealots of the Chantry would uproot all such practitioners if they could. But as luck have it, some still exist. My mother is such a one.
All right, that's all.
Indeed. Have you an opinion on my abilities, then? Am I an unnatural abomination to be put to the torch?
Maybe tied to a flagpole and tickled.
I wouldn't advise it. But enough of such talk. Let us proceed, lest the dust gather on us.
Very well. Oh, and I gained a little bit of approval from her. Good. All right, Alistar. Let's continue on and get this, let's go try and find Arl Eamon, because it sounds like he needs our help. So that's what we're going to do next time. We're going to go to Redcliff Village, which is to our southwest, and I'm going to take the entire group there, minus Morrigan. She can tag along if she wants, but she can stay behind. Everyone else can come with me, and we're going to go to Redcliff Village and meet with Arl Eamon and see if we can get this disease sorted out, because apparently it would be good to have him on our side. So that's what we'll do next time. Until then, my name is Mike, and this has been Dragon Age Origins. Thank you for joining me.